only a shooting star.
Come on, Andy. Everybody's watching on TV. You can't see it if you don't come in.
Can't you see it? Just another wisher.
They chose Eddie Miller instead of me. He gets airsick in cars.
That's why I married you instead of Eddie Miller.
I thought for sure I was getting up there this time.
This is an engine test.
You get your chance next time.
Primary objective of the test.
You're damn right I will. You're not going to be the only one in this family to walk on the moon.
Think of the bright side of this one. You get to spend your summer with me at Space Camp.
Oh, no.
You promised.
Terrific! I get to play Let's Pretend I'm an Astronaut with a bunch of kids.
Hey, these aren't just kids, you know. These are clean cuts. All American kids.
Recognize them anywhere. Clean cut, well motivated, all American.
Hey! Great boosters!
Hey.
Turn that down.
What?
Would you mind turning that down?
Okay, okay. No sweat.
You want Space Camp?
No. My father wants Space Camp, but I want my head examined. But it was worth it for the car, don't you think?
Yeah, well, let's hope so.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
By the way, would you get your ass out of my parking spot?
Oh. Yeah, right. Sorry about that. Oh, space age technology, huh? Have a good summer.
How many times must I say I love you? For you finally understand. Won't you be my forever woman? Try to be your forever man. Try to be your forever man. Rebel man, rebel man.
Check that left mag, Dad. It's sticking.
Okay.
Welcome aboard, campers. I'm Zach Bergstrom, director of Space Camp. We're gonna train you just like NASA trains astronauts. I didn't say real astronauts because at Space Camp, you are real astronauts.
Robert Pickett, purple team. Lonnie Fowler, red team.
Catherine Fairley.
Catherine Fairley?
Blue team.
Hideo Takamine.
Hideo Takamine?
Blue team.
Kevin Donaldson, yellow team.
Dennis Anderson, you're at the green team.
Susan Lang, on the green team.
Great. How about you?
Green.
Ricky Powell, you're on the purple team.
David Joe, white team.
Chris Chu, white team.
Okay, everybody.
Sandra Johnson,
let's all gather in the rocket park.
David Snyder,
the other members of your team and your counselors. Keep your bags here. You can pick them up later.
What? Johnny,
come on, everybody. Let's
yellow
move it.
Just the other purple team.
1,300 hours.
4 years ago, Space Camp was created not only to provide you with hands-on access to space hardware, but also to teach you how to work together as a team. Hi, I'm Andy Bergstrom.
You're an astronaut, the first female pilot.
Yeah, how did you know that?
I've read all about you in the Young Astronauts program. I mean, let's see, you were the backup pilot for the first Discovery flight. But Coates got it instead?
Yeah, I remember.
What are you doing here?
Hello. And what is your name?
Rudy Tyler, ma'am.
Spit it out, Rudy.
Rudy Tyler, ma'am!
I meant the gum, Rudy. You look like a guy with a lot of energy. I'm making you mission specialist number one, equipment function and operation.
Oh, wow. Thanks, man. You know, my father told me that when you come to space camp, they give you all kind of different...
We'll talk about later, okay? Oh, by the way, this is space camp and not the Marine Corps.
Yes, ma'am.
You can call me Andy.
Andy.
Hi, Andy. I'm Tish. Tish Imbrose.
Right there. Yes. So what brings you to space camp, Tish?
Well, I did this audit at JPL in radio astronomy. It was unbelievable. I mean, can you imagine an extraterrestrial disc jockey, like, listening to radio waves from space? I mean, like, waiting for signs of intelligence?
Mm-hmm. Like, I know the feeling. I'm gonna make you mission specialist number two, communications.
Oh, cool.
Max, what are you doing here?
Checking in for my next mission against the Empire, Your Highness.
Your next mission is to haul ass back to junior camp right now.
Oh, come on, Andy. I've been a junior two summers running. Don't kick me out.
You're just not ready.
I am too ready.
Okay, one screw up and you're back in the little leagues. Got it?
Copy, Rogue Leader. Roger now.
Hideo Takamine.
Hideo Takamine?
Right here.
Hideo Takamine?
Well, actually, it's pronounced Kevin Donaldson.
I don't have a Donaldson.
Well, I have one now.
I'm Catherine Fairley. And it's an honor to meet you. Sorry.
It's okay. Okay, I have two positions left, pilot and shuttle commander. Kevin, why don't you tell me why you'd like to be shuttle commander?
I wouldn't. No. Actually, I was thinking more along the lines of mission regent or sovereign, maybe? Something like that.
Mm. Catherine, what about you?
I know a lot about the space program. And I'm going into the Air Force Academy.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to be the first female shuttle commander.
You think that's more important than pilot?
Oh, yeah.
It's okay. Let her have it, because I don't really care.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, now that you're shuttle commander, you're going to have to start to care, aren't you, Kevin?
Yes,
Catherine, you can be pilot.
But...
pilot.
This is a mock-up of the cargo bay and the storage pallets. That arm is the remote manipulator system. It can be used for repairs and to link up with satellites or other vehicles. This is a zero-gravity chair. It rides on a cushion of air, which creates the feeling of weightlessness you would encounter when you leave the Earth's atmosphere. Come on, Max.
Oh, I mean, this is like the greatest thing since an X-Wing fighter.
This is the shuttle simulator, which you're going to learn to fly at speeds of up to Mach 25. I know it looks complicated now, but when you get the basics down, it's real easy. In fact, the computer does most of the work. Now, the first lesson I want to teach you is...
Whoa!
Why
I won't touch anything until I know how to use it.
By Rudy Tyler.
Right.
Yeah, Rudy.
Is everybody okay? This is the Mercury Sigma 7. When they were building these capsules, the astronauts demanded the engineers create a way for them to be able to pilot the capsule back through the re-entry through the Earth's atmosphere. Otherwise, they would feel like the monkeys in the
air. Ah! What the hell was that?
Prototype maintenance droid. NASA built them for the space station.
When's he going up?
He's not. They blew it on his shielding. His chips become unpredictable in about 2 hours.
He's such a complex piece of machinery, NASA hasn't been able to iron out all the bugs. So he helps out here and at Kennedy.
James!
Midget extraterrestrial!
No, he's the world's only $27 million handyman.
Where the hell is that ratchet?
In your hand.
He's also quite literal. Okay, we've all met Jinx. Let's get going. Max. Come on.
Third stage separation before it gets into orbit.
Dennis, I got you that manual. Let me
see. How many pounds of thrust does the shuttle produce at liftoff?
6,981,400.
How'd you know? How in the world she know all that?
Not me. You know, that Kevin is a real babe. He's a jerk.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. He's completely unserious.
Did you check out the size of his hands?
Earth to Catherine. Come in, please.
What are you doing? I'm trying to figure out how to run this thing. See.
What, multi-axis trainer?
Mm-hmm. It's one of the toughest parts of the training. Scary for a pilot. You know anything about it?
Three concentric circles spinning in different directions simultaneously. Object to stabilize from central point utilizing hand controls. You want a piece?
How'd you know all that?
Remember everything I read. It's a real drag sometimes. My mind gets totally cluttered.
What'd you get on your SATs?
800s. You ever, like, talk about anything aside from learning things?
You know, you're real pretty.
Kind of understated.
But you got great eyes. You know, I could do this great makeup job on you.
Guys go for eyes. Kind of.
Guys go for what I haven't got. Makeup's not gonna help. Thanks a lot.
What's your essay gonna be about?
Why? I'm gonna be the first female shuttle commander.
That's gonna go down real big.
And you'll get a kick out of that. What's yours gonna be about?
I want to go into space to contact life forms that exist on chemicals other than carbon and oxygen.
You should visit my high school.
So we struck this deal. Like, he got me to space camp, and I got me a Jeep. what are you doing here?
I want to be the first guy to have a fast food franchise in space. Rudy T's.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Some guy in the space station is going to get a Big Mac attack. Rudy T's going to be there.
That's why you're here?
Well... I like learning. Some guys in my school, they say, yo, Rudy, man, how come you taking science? You don't need to be taking science, man. They don't ask me if I like science.
Do you like science?
Yeah, I love science. Now ask me if I'm any good at it.
That's so hot, huh?
Some things I just can't figure out.
It's a bummer, man. My philosophy is to sleep late, drive fast, and not take any of this shit seriously. Straight up.
Let me see it, kid.
Come on.
I like
this. Who are you, the Imperial Guard or something?
Come on, kid. What do you got in there anyway? Just take a look.
Hey, what's going on?
This kid's got this thing in there.
Yeah, we just want to see it.
Why don't you evaporate laser brain?
Yeah, I'll give
you
laser
brain. Hey, lay off the kid.
Let's take a look. Wow, look at that.
Holy shit.
Shit. Solid waste aboard space station can be handled in one of two ways.
Jinx!
First,
Jinx!
Unsterilized.
Cancel! Okay, get down.
Wow. What is it? What's it do?
Anything you ask him to.
Sure moves slow.
Hey, yo, Jinx, shake a leg.
Don't do that!
Oh, man, you mean he literally does what he's told. Hey, Jinx, move over here, buddy.
All right, Jinx.
Wait, stop it!
Get down and do it!
Take off!
Oh, play it!
Hey, stop!
Unbelievable!
Right
on! Look at your ears!
Jinx!
Hey, man.
Let's get out of here. It's broken. Let's get out of here.
Sorry, kid.
Servos activating. Sensor generators are okay. Image analyses are clean. Put your shield on now, Jinx. Don't worry. Be okay. I'm here with your buddy Max. And when I'm done with you, you'll be as good as new. Yo, Jinx. Yo, Jinx.
Yo.
Jerk-offs did that too. What a bunch of monkey clones. They ought to be zapped. Hey, where are you going?
To zap them!
Hey, stop it! There you go again. Why do you have to take everything so literally?
How else should I take it?
No, Jinx, it's okay. Don't worry, you'll be okay. You know? You're really neat, Jinx.
You too, Max.
Friends forever?
Friends forever.
By the time you leave space camp, you will know the function of every circuit on the shuttle. You may never get the chance to fly in it, but it won't be because you don't know how. If you ever get to be astronauts, you're going to thank us for making you wear these jumpsuits because they provide ease of movement and additional storage space in orbit. The cushions of air the zero-gravity chair rides on helps you simulate the weightlessness you'd experience during EVA. extravehicular activity. That's the work you'd be doing outside the shuttle. To work in space, you have to know how to move it. Don't push off, Tish. Nothing will stop you unless you're acted upon by an outside force. Catherine, it's your job as a pilot to monitor all the onboard systems and feed that data to Kevin, who, as commander, is in charge of the orbiter. You can suit up in your EMU in 5 minutes, Rudy, once you get the hang of it. EMU, that's extravehicular mobility unit. You're gonna need it to do any activity in the vacuum of space. Catherine, give me the coordinates of the space station at 0100 hours. You have to call up whatever information I ask for in a moment. Split-second decisions are essential. You're traveling at 17,000 miles an hour. There is no room for error. You'll find your spacesuit stored in the airlock. You're on your own there when you depressurize as you prepare to move from the cabin environment into the cargo bay. Okay, Catherine, now it's your turn in the multi-axis trainer. This is one of the most critical tasks to master. Especially if you want to achieve top ranking here as a shuttle pilot. Secure? Okay, you have 30 seconds to stabilize.
Here you go.
30 seconds. All right, start it up. If the shuttle is spinning when it re-enters the Earth's atmosphere, the astronaut has just seconds to stabilize. He might enter a flat spin. Keep your head centered. Don't turn it right or left. Push your stick forward.
I got it.
15 seconds. You're yawing to the right. Turn it left.
Go right, right. Come on, you can.
Come on, Catherine. You're not a passenger. You're a pilot. Fly it.
I'm trying.
You've got 10 seconds.
Oh, I'm gonna be sick.
5 seconds. Come on, Catherine, fly it. Okay, shut it off.
Why'd you stop? I would have gotten in another minute.
Another minute, you would have been burnt up on re-entry. Come on and get out. We're running late.
Andy, I can do it. You're just not giving me a chance.
All right. 5 minutes. But that's all. Come on, Kevin. Okay, next I'm going to show you how to strap yourselves into our orbital exerciser. Rudy, you want to go first?
What are you doing?
A microgravity environment is the equivalent to long bed rest, causing heart to weaken.
No, I wouldn't let Andy get to you like that.
I wouldn't please her if I spent the rest of my life trying.
Well, why do you want to please anybody but yourself?
I don't know.
I'm not an expert, but it seems to me that you just... If you just eased up on the thing, you could handle it. You know, you're just trying too hard.
Maybe we have something in common.
You know, there's this full moon tonight.
Wait, you turn into a werewolf or something like that?
No, but I know this great place where we could check the shuttle out.
Caught breaking curfew. No way.
Well, if I can handle that, here you go.
All right.
Say, Max, you got a minute? Now, you've been coming here for a couple of years, right? What's the best way to get to the beach?
You gonna ask him?
Shh. Distract and destroy the Imperial Guard.
Got 10 seconds.
All right, what would Luke Skywalker do? How would he get the launch pad?
Kid's gonna go for the droid.
Yo, Jinx.
Yo, Max.
Jinx, what's the best way to the launch pad?
go out to main gate, go to highway, turn left.
That takes me right by Zach Bergsman's office. There's gotta be some...
Is there another way to the launch pad, James? A secret way?
Secret? Turn left before Zach's office, turn right at Rocket Park, avoid maintenance building, go east, depending on ground speed, beach can be reached between 5 minutes, 7 seconds, and 15 minutes, 12 seconds.
Can you believe that I can go from the Earth up into the stars? God. Look, there's the Seven Sisters.
Oh, yeah?
So beautiful up there. I wish it was like that down here.
So, you're really into this space stuff, huh?
Yeah. Ever since I was a little girl.
Yeah?
Yeah. My dad used to take me up in his plane and hold me on his lap. And sometimes at night, I used to reach out and try to touch the stars. I couldn't wait to grow up.
What's so special about going up?
In space, anything is possible. I mean, maybe we could even do things right up there. I don't know. Instead of screwing them up like we have down here.
Yeah, but, what's the point? I mean, we're all gonna get nuked anyway.
Kevin, that's just an excuse for people who are afraid to try.
Hold it 1 second here. It's not that I'm afraid to try. It's just that, I don't know. I just don't care, I guess.
Yes, you do.
Oh, I do, huh?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's just that it's easier to say you don't care than it is to try and then fail. I know.
I'll never tell. Torture me, kill me, I'll still never tell.
Fess up. Where's Kevin?
Max is gonna get it.
Catherine's gone, too.
All right. Where are Kevin and Catherine?
Kevin and Catherine are at launch pad. It is a secret.
Jinx!
Max!
Let's go.
You cleared it.
Yeah, well, I kind of cleared it.
Yeah, kind of. Ah, shit.
I'll just be a minute.
We were just talking. That's not the point, and you know it.
Nobody cares about Space Camp more than I do. And you've been on my case since day one. Why?
first time I met you, I saw it in your eyes. It's like looking in a mirror. You're special, Catherine.
Why are you so hard on me?
Because someday you're going up. The only way you will is if you have every drill down better than everyone else. There's no room for mistakes. Every I dotted, every T crossed. That's the way I learned it. That's the way you'll learn it. You copy?
Talked.
It wasn't me, Han Solo. The Emperor got information out of Jinx.
Max, I'm not Han Solo, okay? And you're not Luke Skywalker. There's no Empire, and there's no Force, and there's no dark side, okay? You're just an ordinary kid, and so am I, and maybe nobody ever lives happily ever after, all right? So just stay away from me. Far away.
In space.
Hello, Jinx. How can NASA help you?
Put Max in space.
There is no Max listed in astronaut program.
There is now.
How come I have to do all the dangerous stuff?
Dale Gardner did this on Discovery 51A.
It's okay.
Somehow I don't think that's gonna make him feel any better.
range scale at orbit, primary.
Roger, primary and secondary.
Okay. Enter ohms, one burn program, pilot.
Roger, ohms one, commander.
Stand by, pilot.
Atlantis, this is Control. We have orbit confirmed. 125 nautical miles, inclination of 35 degrees. You are in position for satellite recovery.
Good, man. You're on.
Rudy's the best on the RMS. Don't worry about a thing, Max. Rudy knows this arm like the back of his hand.
Oh! Oh, sorry, Rudy. Nice. I didn't know. Oh, you were there.
Come on.
I almost dropped Max.
Rudy! Instigate emergency power loss scenario.
Killing power, sir.
Somebody get me down from here or I'm gonna be sick!
Rude, relax, man. You're freaking out. Control, this is Atlantis. We're experiencing electrical failure. Switching to auxiliary cells.
Listen, that's my decision, not yours,
no,
okay?
Wait, it's that one.
I know, it's right here. It's the green one right next to the red.
Oh! Whoa! Rudy, what are you doing?
I think that was the wrong one. I got it right now. Here you go.
Help! Rudy, just crosswire.
Hey, sit down. Sit down. That's an orb.
I got this. This one right here.
Just forget it.
Well, just sit down. I can handle it. Oh,
yeah. What the hell is going on in there?
We're showing another Ohm's burn.
Yeah, well, the pilot must have hit the switch when she got up.
Yeah.
Okay.
Why isn't she at her post?
Well, she's just too busy doing everybody else's job.
Orbit's decaying, shuttle.
Okay, take over, Commander.
Hey, it's not my job, man. I mean, you like the pilot to do that question. I'm sick and tired of doing no more maneuvers, man.
You're falling out of orbit, Atlantis. You're coming up on atmospheric interface. You're gonna be toast.
Wow! My God!
Careful, Danger. Lot of live
stuff. The wrong one. It's not this one.
Pilot, do you copy? Pilot.
I'm sorry, Catherine's not in right now, but if you'd like to leave your name and number at the tone, she'd be glad to get back to you.
You're coming up on interface, Atlantis.
Roger that, Atlantis. Ladies and gentlemen, please return your seats and tray tables to their full upright positions and extinguish all smoke and material as we're about to land in the red zone.
No survivors!
We're gonna
Captain, we're not gonna fuck if you just listen to me for a second.
That's right. You're gonna
stop it. Stop it!
I'm sorry, but Rudy was.
Yeah,
Rudy!
I don't wanna hear about it. I can't hear it. You know why? Because you're all dead.
You just disintegrated during re-entry. Huh? Don't you understand what that means? You're all dead because you didn't work together as a team. And you're responsible.
Me?
That's right, you. You're shuttle commander. That means you are responsible for everything that happens on this ship.
I didn't ask to be responsible, remember?
It's a pitiful excuse for killing four people.
Oh, God. I don't believe this. Look, nobody got killed, okay? I mean, it's just space camp.
Launch possibilities.
What are possibilities of launching Max into space?
There is no possibility at this time.
This is not going to be easy.
Hello, Commander Bergstrom.
Well, hi, you two. How you doing?
What's a FRF?
That's FRF. Flight Readiness Firing. That's how NASA tests the main engines of the shuttle. This is the first year we got permission for you guys to experience it. And some of you aren't even going to be able to sit in this. I'll get an astronaut's point of view. See ya.
Engine test. Jinx must be ready Thursday, 4 p.m.
Thank you.
X on shuttle during engine test. How do we change engine test into liftoff?
Worst-case scenario, thermal curtain failure.
Define thermal curtain failure.
Failure of heat shielder engine test. Only one booster will ignite. Result force launch.
Why launch?
If you do not light the second booster and launch, the shuttle will lift off and crash.
That is unacceptable.
To avoid worst-case scenario, second booster must be ignited. Result perfect launch.
Thermal curtain failure possibilities.
One thermal curtain failure every 4.9 million years.
Max won't live that long. Max needs thermal curtain failure. Max and Jinx. Friends. Forever.
I can't believe our luck. We get to sit inside the shuttle.
Control at T-minus 60 minutes until the test firing of the three main engines aboard Atlantis. At this time, the orbiter test is done.
Pretty cool, huh?
The verification programs on target.
God, it must be about
4 o'clock p.m. ignition.
You all right?
Yeah.
You heard a few minutes ago the Lockheed test director briefing the test team.
I can't believe our luck.
Countdown cutoff procedure.
Engine test into launch. Max into space.
Our NASA test director will be verifying.
Hey, you guys, we don't have a lot of time in here. Watch your heads when you come in. Signed in the simulator. Catherine and Kevin, get up in your seats.
Take it up on
Kevin, just hop up. There you go.
The only thing missing here is a tape deck.
Pilot commander, strap in. Oh, this is amazing.
It's better than the Millennium Falcon.
I can't believe that they actually fly this. Max, Tish, take your seats on the mid deck. If you need any help, just holler.
Okay. Roger, commander. All on the laser guns. May the force be with you.
Please put on your helmets and make sure that your headsets are plugged in. Pilot commander, unstow cue cards.
Roger.
Cue cards. Right.
APU fuel.
Right, RSC crossfeed.
Is everybody set?
Roger.
Roger.
Kevin, look at that.
It's a bunch of numbers tonight.
Control, this is Atlantis. Do you copy?
Roger, Atlantis. This is launch control.
Radio check, over.
Solid rocket boosters A and B, ignition off. Stand by for main engine test.
Stand by. Atlantis, do you copy?
She's all yours.
Go ahead.
What, are you sure?
Yeah. Come on, we answered him, man.
Control, this is Atlantis. Radio check satisfactory. Over.
Alright, that Catherine!
Stand by for FRF ignition. Counting down. T minus 10.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go for main engine test.
Thermal curtain failure.
9, 10.
Oh my God!
13, 14, 15. Thermal curtain failure. Max and Jinx, friends forever.
3, 4, 5.
We have overheat on booster B.
Temperature? 1200 degrees and climbing. Get that thing operational.
The thermal curtain is failing.
Permanent to test.
We're past shutdown temperature. We can't stop it.
We have thermal curtain failure.
What does that mean? Andy!
Booster B, temperature is critical.
Catherine, get out of there now!
Andy, make them stop! Make them turn it off!
They're trying!
Booster B is near ignition. It's gonna light.
Right, Booster A, goddammit, launch us or we're gonna explode!
What's happening?
Please, Andy!
Grab her, Rudy!
Do it.
Zach, we're not authorized.
Light it or they're gonna die.
Ignite Booster A!
5, 4,
arm booster ignite.
Booster dice on.
Rudy, hold on to her! Try it!
Go for launch! Now!
Light it. You're looking good.
Hey. You want to take it?
Andy.
Jesus Christ, Zach.
Guess you're not going to have to wait so long after all. Andy, you're going to have to throttle. Atlantis. This is control. Throttle.
Copy control. Main engines at 65%.
SRV set.
Landis, this is control. Press for Miko. You are go for main engine cutoff.
Roger.
This will be the lead story on 11 o'clock.
Miko is on schedule. Over.
I don't know where this drill's gonna end, baby. Hang in there.
Roger. Miko is on schedule. Over.
Andy?
Control, this is Atlantis. Do you read? Over.
Atlantis, we're losing her.
This bird wasn't flight ready, Zach. They only have short range radio.
Shit! Kevin, we have Miko. Go for ET step on my mark. 3, 2, 1. Do you know where it is?
Think so.
Mark!
Got it.
They got their arms burned. They're still climbing.
Come on.
Tracking reads, Atlantis at 180 by 33. They're in orbit.
I didn't touch a thing, Andy. Honest.
I know, Rudy. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I think we've achieved orbit.
Jesus.
Catherine, are you okay?
I think so.
You're floating.
Just relax and allow yourself to flow with it.
Wow. I could lose a liftoff, but this is incredible.
Wow. Weightlessness. This is unreal.
I feel like I'm flying.
You're in space, Kevin. I can't believe it.
Max, Fish, are you okay?
Tell me why.
Oh, I feel sick.
Gonna die.
We're already dead.
It's just like a dream.
Kevin, is this incredible or what? You got more guts than me, Rudy. Man coming through.
It's like magic.
Max, you gotta try this flying. Watch your head, Max!
Are you all in one piece?
Yeah.
I think so.
Oh, good.
Ah, Jesus.
Well, I think we have a few things to talk about.
A few things?
Yeah. Catherine?
Touch the stars now, huh?
Oh,
man. Whoa.
Wow. Let me see. Is that Earth?
Sure is, Max.
There's the coast of Africa right there.
Yeah.
And there's the Swiss Alps.
It goes by so fast. Amazing sunset.
Stay up here forever.
Me too.
Wasn't it supposed to be a safety?
How did this happen?
It's not important how it happened. What's important now is how we get back home. We are going home. Folks, I'm gonna need all your help to get there.
Rudy, you and Kevin stowed the aft deck seats.
We'll have no voice contact with NASA. Telemetry is still on. See, the safest procedure will be for them to bring us down on auto at the next available window.
Oh,
windows out there?
No, it's where we re-enter the Earth's atmosphere at the right time and place so we can land at Edwards Air Force Base.
First re-entry for Edwards is in 12 hours. Okay, we just sit tight and we keep everything running till then. In the meantime, I'm gonna check this mother out.
Absolutely unprecedented.
I don't know what to tell you, Ray.
Well, I gotta give some statement. I'm standing right there.
Well, look, all I know is I want that gallery cleared out. If you do me a favor and take those kids back to space camp.
Christ, the president has to be told.
He'll be back in 12 hours, Ray.
How the hell am I supposed to keep a lid on this? People for 500 miles know the shuttle went up.
Tell them the truth. We launched my wife and five kids from the space camp.
They'll never believe it. What you reading, Jim?
Dial 5555.
Zach.
Yeah?
We had to find an early re-entry.
Why? What's the problem?
The shuttle wasn't flight ready. They won't be alive in 12 hours.